Hey everybody, thanks so much for clicking on this video and happy Vlogmas. Just coming on here to do an introduction. I am not going to do the traditional Vlogmas with 25 vlogs. I am going to do 12 days of Christmas. I cannot make a commitment to do 25 vlogs all in a row. May get a few more, but you'll definitely get 12. Hope you enjoy, and as always, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Bye. First, you get a big skillet, line it up with cooking spray. Next, when your chicken is starting to get brown, you can add your taco seasoning. Now, in my instance, based off of the amount of chicken I cooked, I used a half pack of taco seasoning. You can use more or less depending on how much you like. Making sure I get all of that in there. Next, you take a bowl, mix black beans and corn. You can season if you like. Once your chicken is about halfway through, you pull it out of your skillet and begin to dice it up. When the chicken is just about done, you're mixing in your black beans and your corn, stirring everything together to make sure all of the flavor is mixed. Now, before you put the black beans and corn in, you can season those separately, or you can just season everything all together if you want to add anything additional on top of the taco seasoning. Make sure you stir up real good and then let it continue to simmer all together before transferring to a bowl. Once you transfer everything to a bowl, you're going to add your shredded cheese and mix everything together. Sorry, everything looks lopsided because I was trying to hold a camera and stir at the same time. But you just make sure that everything is nice and mixed together so it's not lumping. Now your chicken is going to start looking a little bit black only because of the color from the black beans. So now you can see that everything is mixed together. Everything is piping hot, so you may want to wait until everything is cooled off a little bit. Now to get set up, you're going to need egg roll wraps, wax paper, and a bowl of water. Now to start, you're going to make sure that your egg roll wrap is facing the point down, facing towards you. You're going to put in your desired amount of your chicken mix into the middle of the egg roll wrapper. Then you're going to take that bowl of water and you're going to line your edges with water. Now, for this, you can also use an egg that is scrambled, but I like to use the water because it's a little less messy. You're going to take those ends and then you're just going to roll. And I'm going to do this a total of 3 times in the video. Also, you're going to take some more water and you're just going to seal your edges so that they're nice and clean. Once again, taking that, lining your sides with water or egg, again, depending on your liking. And I forgot to turn this one, but again, make sure that that point is facing towards you so that you get a really good roll. Try to make sure that all of your chicken mix is bunched together. Again, taking that point first, pulling that up, one corner, and roll. And try to make it as tight as possible so that it gives you that egg roll shape. Sealing with water. And for the 3rd time, excuse my ashy elbow. These do tend to stick together, so you want to make sure that you're only using one. Otherwise, you're going to have a super thick egg roll wrap that has to cook. Lining with water, making sure that point is down to you. Making sure the ingredients are in only one section. Pull the point. Side. Side. Tuck and roll. Sealing my edges with water. And you keep repeating this until you're done with all of your mix. So now I usually let them sit here just for a couple minutes so they can start to dry a little bit. Then I put them in the air fryer on 350. You want to preheat your air fryer. And I just put the timer on for 20 minutes, but I consistently check them to make sure that they weren't burning. And then you can flip them depending on how much of a color that you want on them. You just want to make sure that they're golden. The ingredients are done in the inside. This is more so just to cook your actual egg roll wrapper. And like I said, you can keep rotating them with a fork or tongs until you get them to the color that you desire to have them with. Grab you some ranch and dip and go crazy. Now, you can fry these. Normally, I fry them. This is a batch of spinach and cheese that I did last year for a bridal shower. And you can fry these just like how you fry a piece of chicken or pork chops or anything like that. Nothing changes with regards to how you make them. You're literally just submerging them in grease and, you know, draining the excess grease off of them. The air fryer version is just a alternative where I guess you can call it slightly healthier. That way you're not using the grease and it's not fried. Well, air fried versus using actual physical grease.